Here's a standard scissor linkage. You've probably seen something like this before. It extends, it retracts, it has 1 degree of freedom. Now, what if you wanted only half of the scissor linkage, say this gray half, but you still wanted to act like a scissor linkage? Well, here you go. Ignore all the gears for a minute. I can extend and retract it in exactly the same way. It has 1 degree of freedom. And just to prove that these two things really work in exactly the same way, and sort of put one on top of the other, I've got these bolts that I can put in to line up the ends. There we go. And then they move in exactly the same way. Actually, there are a couple of differences. So the gears kind of get in the way and they stop it retracting as far as the standard scissor linkage can. On the other hand, the standard scissor linkage gets stuck here, right? You can't go past this position here, whereas the half scissor linkage goes right through straight and can collapse on the other side. Okay, so how does this work? The gears are obviously doing something, so let me take some of them off to show you what's going on. All right, so now it acts like you'd expect if you just removed half of the ordinary scissor linkage. If you just remove the green bits here, then this is just going to be a floppy chain of sticks, just like this. There are lots of ways it can move, lots of degrees of freedom. Now let's see what happens when I add back in one of the gears, except that I'm going to use these shiny green gears to make it clearer what's going on. All right, so now I've got this green gear in here, and what that does is it forces these two sticks to stay parallel to each other because it is gearing into these two gears here. Let's do one more. And now that this green gear is in here, that's forcing these two sticks to stay parallel. And now these three sticks are parallel because of these two gears. Okay, so there we go, we're back to where we were before. And again, it has 1 degree of freedom. You might have noticed that these two gears at the end don't really do anything. Unless you're adding more sticks onto either end, they're not making it have any fewer degrees of freedom. But they make it look better, so I put them on. Talking of looking good but not doing anything, no, I don't know why half of a scissor linkage is useful for anything. But it is interesting that you can make gears act like a linkage. Here's a question, can you make a linkage act like gears? This is such a simple mechanism that I wouldn't be surprised if somebody already made it out of Lego Technic decades ago, but I don't think I've seen it before. I got to it by thinking about Oscar van Deventer's tailspin mechanism. Here there are also a bunch of what essentially are sticks in a chain, but here the angle between neighboring sticks is always the same in the same direction. In the half scissor linkage, the angle is also always the same, but they alternate directions, turning right then left, whereas here they're always turning to the left. That's what the extra gear in the middle of each stick does. It reverses the movement. The tailspin mechanism is essentially this, except that these two gears here are in contact, making them rotate in the same direction. If you want to make one of these yourself, I've put a link to the 3D printing files in the description. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching.